As Kral, or whatever the fuck.
Well now, looky here. We got us a smooth skin that I ain't ever seen before. I'm Azrakal.
Azrakal!
This is the ninth.
Oh, is it?
Circle.
Is it? That's so cool.
Folks got problems, and I got liquor to sell them. Well, liquor and a few other pick-me-ups. You need anything, you just let me know.
Well, I can let you know. Who's the guy in the corner?
That's Sharon. Let's just say, well, he's a loyal employee. Don't mess with me, and he won't mess with you.
Well, he mentioned... He's talking about something else. Lincoln Memorial. I want him to put that on my fucking map.
Yeah. Just east of here. Bunch of guys with guns are holding
up. That's where
there.
I want to be. Well, I guess now I know it's east of here, but that doesn't, He didn't put it on my map. Okay, what's the guy in the corner? Alright, he's your loyal employee, so he's your slave.
No, he is not. Ma'am, you insult me. I do not believe in slavery. It is an abomination.
Oh, well gee, isn't that hilarious?
I am a firm believer in personal choice. To force another person into bondage is unthinkable. Chains are earned, never forced.
Well, that is
Sharon
so cool.
Made some choices that landed him in my employ. The matters of our contract is between him and I. No one else.
Okay, so... Well, I want to buy him. He's a loyal employee. What do you mean?
I hold his contract, which makes me his employer. He will do what I ask, when I ask, without question. You see, Sharon grew up around a very interesting group of individuals. Well, I guess you could say that they brainwashed him. He is absolutely loyal to whomever holds his contract. Unfailing, unflinching. Until the day that employment ends.
Well, funny you should say that.
Don't get me wrong. I have no doubt that he holds no end of animosity towards me. But so long as he is my employee, he is as gentle as a teddy bear.
Cool story. I want to talk about his contract.
Oh, would you now? He's a highly valuable asset to me and to the Ninth Circle. What did you have in mind?
Well, I'll give you... Couldn't we work out some sort of deal?
I suppose we could do that, although you might not like the deal that I have to offer. You see, I don't like competition. Not at all. It goes against every principle that I have as a businessman. So the fact that there is another source for booze in town troubles me. Greta, the waitress over at Carol's, I want you to kill her. I don't care how. Just make it quiet. Do it, and you can have Sharon's comfort.
Sweet. All right, sure. Greta is nothing to me. I will do it.
I'm glad to hear it. Come back to me when she's dead, and Sharon's contract is all yours. A word of advice. Be subtle. Open gunplay will only get the town to turn on you, and I will not be able to help you.
Well, alright then. I will see you later.
Drink till
Don't care what you have to say.
I was wondering something. Ask Azrakal. But...
Long time no see. What's going on with you?
Some people...
Yep, well, apparently he does not like that. Alright, I'm gonna put on my little stealth suit. You know, there's this thing, too, with Mr. Crowley. Messing with this armor apparently will complete the quest because, I don't know, it's the armor I got from the,
We don't get a lot of your kind.
It's from the, Operation Anchorage simulation. After you beat it, the simulator, you can, you know, you get this armor and a bunch of other crap. And for some reason, the developers, I don't know, I guess they screwed up somewhere, but, I don't want to talk to this guy. This guy's weird.
Oh.
Hey, look at that. A human. With hair. Hey, you think we can do something about that?
You stay away from my hair.
Oh, come on. I don't ever get to work on an actual human. I'm good. I promise. I'll take a few puffs, and I'll give you the best haircut of your life. No charge or anything. It'll be fun.
Are you taking Jet over here?
Well, yeah. So, what else do I have to do except get high? You think that I need to be sober to cut a ghoul's hair? Half the work is cutting the skin off. These guys don't care how they look anyway. They just humor me.
Well, that is fucking weird. I have to go now. I was thinking that was the guy who had body parts falling off. Watch maybe it is, maybe it isn't. Don't know. Don't really care. Actually, I need to, yep, this is Carol's place. Was that a quest that it put in my thing? Or is that a... Okay. Alright, so it's an unmarked quest going into Carol's place. This will give me a fancy little autosave. So if it doesn't work out, boom, I'll fix the problem at hand. Mr. Crowley, I will be speaking to you.
Hey, you.
I will be speaking
you.
To you
I
in a
talk
bit,
to you.
You asshole.
Hey there.
Greta, you need to go to sleep. Okay, so what I will do is, let's see, it's 3 p.m., so I will wait to... I guess I'll wait till 11. The bitch might be in bed or something then. Where the hell did
hey,
you...
Hey, how's it going?
God damn it. Well, who the hell is this guy? Oh, that's Quinn.
Oh, we hardly ever...
Damn it, Greta, you need to go to sleep. It's like, what do you why need? Are there more and more people in here?
You need something, hon?
No, I have to go now. Okay, I'm talking to you, Mr. Crowley.
What are you looking at? You'd think you'd never seen a ghoul up close before.
I got nothing against ghouls.
Is that so? Even if I call you a milk-sucking, mutant-loving, water-stealing whore.
Well, you got part of that right. Milk-sucking, you shuffle-stipping, brain-eating, grape-loving zombie. All true except for the part about the mutants, the water, and the... Okay, the whore part might be a little true.
Another human bigot.
Aw.
What now? You're starting to pick...
No, I got nothing against ghouls. All true except the part about that thing.
I like a human that knows this place. Too many of you think we're all just zombies.
You're not a zombie?
They don't
what?
Know or don't care that we're just as human as they are inside. We bleed, we hurt, we regret. And you know what really pisses me off? They think the only way to kill us is to shoot us in the head, like in the old zombie stories, and that'll put us out of our misery. Hey, I know. Maybe you could help me even the score.
Let's see, alrighty, no, okay, what's the plan?
Not everyone is as sympathetic to ghouls as you are. In fact, some humans are downright bigots. They treat us like zombies, calling us brain eaters and shufflers. Well, I'm gonna make them pay. Before I get into the details, you don't have anything against killing, do you?
Fuck no! The day isn't complete until I've killed something!
Well, aren't you the bloodthirsty right. type? I got this list of people. Ghoul bigots. Real scum. I've only got 4 guys left on the list. Started out with 11. All of them hate ghouls and treat us like we're zombies. They all deserve to die. But it has to be done with a headshot.
Well, I don't think
like
hatred
stories, where
actually
zombies can only
deserves
be
to
I'll
be
pay
a
you
death sentence.
For
so.
Each one, 25 if they die some other way.
Sure, people like that don't deserve to live. And the interesting thing is, if you do some snooping around, actually you don't even have to snoop, but if you talk to people, they're like, well, he's full of shit. They're not really bigots, except maybe Tenpenny, but, yeah.
Excellent.
Sniper rifle.
Here's a list of the guys and their last known locations. Word will get around if Tenpenny's killed, but I'll need proof for the others.
Well, Tenpenny's dead.
Bring
the ghouls killed him.
Bring me back something personal from each of them as proof, like a key, a ring, or something.
Let's see. Here's Dave's key. He's dead, but not from a shot to the head. Let's see. Alistair Tenpenny's dead, but not from a shot to the head.
Good riddance.
But I didn't get a key. Well, Dave is kind of... Well, he's dead. Well, here's Dave's key. He's dead, but not from a shot to the head. Okay.
I suppose I have to pay you anyway, since you brought back that key.